Thanks. Speaking with Andrew Vigar this morning from Terra Uranium. Andrew, good morning.
Good morning.
Good to talk to you again, Andrew. Good to see you.
A
Athabasca update from you this week. Tell us a bit more about these geochem halos identified at Parker Lake.
Yeah, this is the second last step in our process to target the diamond drilling. We have glacial cover, between 10 and 50 metres of glacial cover across the sandstone bedrock. And this was our last sort of step, if you like. The RC drilled down into the sandstones. We took samples. We have Tom Kotzer, who's Professor Tom Kotzer from Ottawa University, who's one of the leading experts in halos and recognition of uranium anomalies at depth, remembering we're 800 to 900 metres above the unconformity where we are. So we're looking for signatures in the sandstone. In some ways, it's a bit of an advantage because we do get these halos. If the deposits have been eroded further down, they don't tend to be as quite as large and diverse. But the results were excellent. So we thought to keep all our investors in the market up to date, we should release those. And Tom has done a very in-depth analysis, which I think you'll see in the body of the statement. He's an absolute gun, and we're seeing the alteration clays which we're looking for. We're also seeing boron. We're also seeing uranium. It's obviously not all grade. These are halos, so it's the ratios and the comparison to what we would expect as a background. But they're very good results, and over a very long strike length, Andrew, we've got over 20 kilometers of strike length of what we call at Parker a classic Eastern Athabasca conductor, which is a nice linear conductor. There's a really nice graphic done in there by Mike, one of our team, and it really clearly shows that long conductor, but more importantly, some nice little breaks and offsets, which is where the mineralization tends to concentrate. You know, everything's based on conductors and major fault zones that bring the fluids in.
And you say Discovery International Geophysics, they did a EM survey over a key uranium drill target here, did they?
Yes. So based on Tom's work, we just picked a spot there in the middle near one of his anomalous targets. And that's a detail survey. So that's ground-based electrical method that gets you right down to the unconformity and brings us down from sort of hundreds of metres to tens of metres target. That's still being processed and a couple of weeks away, but we've seen the preliminary results, obviously, from the boys on the ground. They're seeing very strong conductors. So on that particular line, there's at least two or three of them, and that'll allow us to target the diamond drilling. So we're down on that final step of our systematic approach now. The rig's on site. There's a nice little shot there of the drill rigs going across the ice lake. Saves us quite a lot of money taking them in by road rather than by chopper. And then when the ice melts and we're ready for the spring-summer program, the rig's already there, ready to go, plus all the consumables. Because these are deep holes. These are 1,000-metre holes.
Are you doing a seismic survey there now?
Passive seismic, yes. We had such success with the system we brought over from Australia at Pasfield. We've now contracted to do a similar program at Parker, just to try and refine that. That'll be done before the diamond drilling. But it works so well at Pasfield, we think we can actually see not only the unconformity, but also some slight variations within it and possibly the impacts of alteration, which is a real game changer. A lot of interest from guys at PDAC about this ANT method. And we know that that some of the big boys in there have already contracted systems to work this summer. So we're at the lead, as always, Andrew.
And as far as the diamond drill program, you'll be drilling at both Parker and Pasfield, will you?
Yeah, Parker was our secondary target. It was always a big and interesting target, but the data was very old. So this is the process of refreshing that data with modern techniques. It's starting to come up now as it's on a par with Pasfield. That's still our main target, but it's such a strong looking structure that we've decided we'll. Well, it's not final decision, but at this stage, yes, we'll probably drill that one first.
Well, Andrew, you mentioned PDAC a bit earlier. How's the attitude? How's the vibe within the uranium space at the moment? What kind of conversations were you having there?
Yeah, I thought it was pretty strong, Andrew. It was a lot of interest in uranium. The turnout was good, 23,000 odd people. And we managed to have, private meetings with a number of the other major players in the basin just to let them know who we are. Our open house was well attended. No, it was a really, really good start to our season. And I think people are realizing that there's a major shortage looming in uranium, primary uranium supply, because of what's happening in Central Asia. You know, Kazakhstan is a major producer. It's largely going to China these days. Can't see that changing much. Australia is a major producer. People want production from stable environments, politically stable environments like Australia or North America.
Good to speak, Andrew. Thanks for your time.
It's a pleasure. Anytime, Andrew.